Delicatessen, hip hop, cracker smacker, jack in the box, Eden master blaster, fuzzy bear guitar, swaggering haggling wordplay, and old school type rap. Grandiloquently self proclaiming, humble, mumble, magnificent.
What are you mumbling, chundering about? I mean, are you really going to be going to this Crip Triptych festering tune?
Yes, and how many times have I got to tell you it's not a Crip Triptych festering tune, it's a triptych music festival.
And how are you going to get there? We're going to have to call handicabs or dialer rides.
Oh, baby, you know how to wind an old trip. I'm going to hitchhike, the good old hippie way.
Hitchhike? Don't be so ridiculous. Nobody hitchhikes anymore. Especially not a trip with a stick. It's so passé. So sell-by date.
Get thee behind me, thy knee'll fight back, I'll outshite you. What we need is a return to the 60s, when young people were young and rebellious, when revolution hung in the air, and our governments wouldn't dare go warmongering.
Oh yeah, peace and flowers, man. You know, it makes me horny. It makes me kind of horny. It makes me kind of horny when you refuse to blow up my spasmataz, man.
You know, getting old is inevitable. Growing up, well, that's a choice, my jolly Joan Baez. Fancy a quickie for the moment.
Oh, my spasmanian devil.
Hey, that's a great name for a band.
His sell-by date.
The red scab's nagged will never be past his sell-by date. Anyway, Dad, you have to bring that thing in here.
It's my bloody house. You're worse than your mother. God bless her soul. And Mr. Scribnibs, or whatever his bloody name is, isn't going to be there anyway. So I don't know why you're bothering going to Triptych. I didn't think it was your scene anyway.
I know, the Red Scabs Nerves isn't performing there. But I have to go and ask, why are people like us excluded? I buy records too. Why can't I see and hear people like me and the Rev Scabs Nabs on stage and on albums?
Because you can't sing.
Oh, thanks. I thought parents were supposed to be encouraging and supportive. Anyway, most of the pop stars these days couldn't sing for toffee. It's all done through digital jiggery-pokery. Post-production electro-alchemical.
You're still going on this mad trip.
I've got to. This is my quest for the Holy Grail. I want to be a rock star. I could be a cross between Janis Joplin, Joan Baez, and Tina Turner. The industry keep rejecting my demos. I want to ask the experts, those that made it, why? What was the secret of their success? Let the
space free. I can tell you without having to trundle up all the way to Glasgow. You're a Crip, period.
I'm still going. I'm going to have my Crip trip whether you like it or not.
It isn't that. I don't like it. I'm just worried. Is it safe? What if you break down?
Will you be there?
Of course, sweetheart. Just give a little whistle. Okay, let the space
clear. Follow the Jello Criptych Road. As 25-year-old born too late to be hippie, punk, grunge, dirt pussy, Vickers Knickers trundles her own road movie from venue to venue, braving the speeding asphalt junkies from penis quick, greasing through the howling bowels of Edinburgh to arty-tarty Glasgow in her auto, S&M motorised, electric, eclectic wheelchair.
Picking up on the way, Hitch-hiker Crip with a stick, post-mod, Earnest, Weegie, Cyber-Cypher, Perv, punk poet, Prince Vincent, all gob-shite and no trousers.
Heave-ho, the Triptych Trio, the Frio, that's not the road to Rio.
Must make the 53 giga cycle in 5 days.
Impossible, says Prince Vincent, riding her from behind like a slaphead Santa, screaming mush to phantom sleigh-pulling huskies.
Don't be a wuss, replies Vickers Knickers, as she charges the battery of a supersonic honking bonking electric wheelchair. Occasionally rescued by her gladiator dad on a bike who repairs the ever-increasing bouts of interruptive blown, complaining groaning motor and Dalek control.
Denying the disability steroid type and road raging the highway with a law mowing killing machine.
We all live in a mellow submachine, a mellow submachine, a mellow submachine. We all live in a mellow submachine, a mellow submachine, a mellow submachine. We all live in a mellow submachine, a mellow submachine, a mellow submachine.
They chant, remembering funny farm coach trips to the seaside.
Guess why she wants to catch Belle and Sebastian Smuck's Vince the Invincible? She expects to see a cute boy on a Pyrenean mountain bike.
You can talk, wolf maniac. You'll see anything with wolf in the title. Wolf eyes in name only, with probably no real bite at all. Victoria Riposte.
Up yours, Blair. I'll support an Arab strap across his arse, Prince Vincent says.
Think something with Arab is anti-war? Better go for Top Cat if you hunger for bush baiting fodder. Victoria asks as she dictates into his dictaphone, my latest novel.
Yeah, and you think you're going to get the answers to the question, how can I be a Crip rock chick in a wheelchair? The music industry is as body fascist as any other show business.
Oh yeah? Victoria retorts. And what about the successes of Ian Jury, Radiohead, Stevie Wonder, the Reverend Scabs Nabs?
Who? Never heard of him, Vince Unconvinced asks with a heavy fumbling breath.
You bloody turf hobbler. You never heard of his underground hit, Blind, Crippled and Black?
Hey, look over there. It's the Reverend Scabs Nabs.
Yeah. being young, being foolish. I let my gambler lead me astray. My mama, she's a tailor. She sewed your blue jeans when they were new. My sweetheart, he's a drunkard. He's drinking down in New Orleans. When I was a young girl, I used to seek pleasure. When I was a young girl, used to drink ale. Hold of an ale house into this jail. My body's ruined. They left me here to die. It's 16 pretty maidens carry my coffin, 16 pretty maidens to sing me a song. The bunches of roses over my coffin, so I look pretty as I ride. Go tell my baby sister, don't do what I have done. Shun that house in New Orleans, they call the rising sun. There is a house
festival, the trip. Oh, I can't believe my luck. How do you get on?
Just hop on the back.
Hey, this'll be interesting. Yep.
What's your name, by the way?
Vincent, as in Prince Vincent, as in Vincent Van Gogh. Although I've got 2 years of.
Really?
What's your name?
Victoria.
Vickers. Vickers, can I make this? How long have you been travelling?
Oh, a day or so.
On your own?
Yeah, I like it.
I'll tell you, see, if you hadn't picked me up there, I was dead, man. I was
really?
Finished. I tried to hitchhike earlier on. Some guy in a car almost ran me over, the bastard. I mean, what was that about?
Well, they're all miserable gits these days.
Some people, man, they've no soul, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
No, like, what's in your knickers and knickers?
You fucking what?
Oh, joking. So, are you going to see?
Oh, you know, Arkestra, Wolf Eyes, Odetta.
Thank you.
shit, what happened here?
Oh God, I don't know. Oh God. Here, let me try it. Hang on. No, it's not working. It's not working.
Kicking it down or what?
No, I don't think that will help.
Okay, right. What are we doing then? Is this anything? It's nothing, is that?
Kick it or something. No, that's
well,
not
it's
it.
It's nothing, is it? Oh. I don't see any.
No. No, that's just. No, nothing.
I don't see anything, Liz. Can we? There's a bit here. Nothing at all, no.
But it's splashing like crazy. Okay, I'm gonna have to call Dad.
Dad?
Yeah, Dad, he'll sort it. Hang on. Hello, Dad? Hi, Dad? Yeah, it's Victoria. Hi, listen, I've broken down. I don't know, I think it's something to do with the connection. Would you be able to come and sort me out? Okay, thanks. Okay, yeah, I'll see you in 5. Okay, cheers then, bye.
You see him in 5?
Yeah.
How's he going to know where you are?
He'll manage, he'll find us.
You sure?
Yeah. Oh, so now we've got to sit and wait. Thanks.
Can't see a bloody thing.
We need to try these magic mushrooms.
Really?
Here, come on.
Hold a ship. One night dress for this. One night leave now.
far too brown. Committed stones. I hear the sounds I know. But you know the walls begun. And after all we've done, I got those restless blues again. This morning, Odetta, I'm on a bounce again. I'll tuck in those wires again. We dream of the promised land. Talk of the day we'd raise a storm.
Any problem?
Sorry, I was looking for that. Handling wheelchair there.
Yeah. Will you get your hand off me, please? Oh, fucking hell! What's your problem?
Okay, right. I won't do it again, mate. I promise. I promise I won't do it again.
Get your hand off me!
Your wife,
that's right!
So Wolfsides, where did you get the name?
I guess I stole the name.
Well, yeah. That's honest.
Yeah. That's the main thing. I definitely did steal the name. Uh-huh. From Paul Winter. Uh-huh. He has an album called Wolf Eyes. The first Wolf Eyes cassette is a loop of Paul Winter. God, I hope I don't get in trouble for this.
Sued.
You know, he is an intro with just all wolves like howling. And the first Wolf Eyes tape is just a loop of the wolves howling.
Then, in terms of your music and stuff like that.
Anything that is devoted to the absolute hatred of humanity.
This stuff right over here. This over here. Uh-huh. If you get this over here, this is our influence.
Old carpets.
All this stuff right here.
In spite of carpets.
Trash and garbage.
Jump buggers. These are the real weapons of mass destruction. Fucking piss. Well, trash and garbage, what's your attitude to the politics of Bush and Blair?
Well, I mean, we definitely aren't a very political band. That doesn't enter in our music. Uh-huh. I mean,
some people say that musicians and the music they create should affect change and have something to say about the society they find themselves in.
We feel not so much political, but we feel like we're music from Michigan. You know, in many ways, people ask us what kind of music we play, and it's Michigan folk music.
Michigan folk music.
Yeah. I mean, that's completely what it is.
Yeah.
We don't necessarily enter, you know, worldly politics in our
music. No one wants to hear anyone preach.
What's the difference between Scotland and America? Fucking nothing. Coca-Cola. Chemical warfare.
But of course we fucking hate Bush, you know? We know that.
Yeah, I mean,
we wouldn't be playing the music we did if we didn't hate him.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Jesus! Now I know why America's fucked!
Is that the press officer for Odetta? My name's Victoria. I called yesterday. I'm just ringing up to inquire about the possibility of getting an interview with her. She's not going to give any interviews. Oh, why did I want to speak to her? Oh, well, really, I just thought she'd be such an inspirational figure to speak to.
Nobody knows you when you're down and out. In my pockets, not a penny. And my friends, well, I can't find any. If I ever get back on my feet again, I'll go and see my lost friends. Mighty strange. Nobody knows you when you're down and out.
I myself am trying to break into the music industry. But I'm a disabled person, and I find that there's a lot of hostility towards the notion of someone such as myself, you know, with the way that I look and everything, trying to make it in the business. You know, they hear my demo tapes, they like what I sound like, they just say, oh, well, the look's all wrong, you know. So I thought Odetta might be able to offer some advice. You know, she understands about oppression, being black, being a woman, you know, and being very political in her own work and using her role as an artist to get the message across. So you know, I thought it would be good. But you say she's not going to give any interviews. Okay, yeah, thanks. Bye.
Once I lived the life of a millionaire, spent all my money, I did not care. I took my friends out, had a good time, buying good old whiskey, champagne, and wine. Then I began to fall so low. Didn't have a friend and no place to go. Never get my hands on a dog again. Hope you'll do too, baby, eagle green.
Before
they
think about that.
Instead of spending on festivals. And it's changed without a doubt. Nobody knows. nobody knows. Don't recognize you. Just can't use you. Honey, honey.
Look at the man across the road lying like that, you know what I mean? He doesn't need to be lying like that. He could be lying in a nice warm bed, no lying on the street like that.
Council leave people to die.
Like, that's what the Leavers like,
because they'll no help us or that. They'll no help any of us. You know what I mean?
And that's what drives us to drugs, basically, is begging and stuff like that. You know what I mean? So basically, there's nothing else for it except for do that or shoplift or stuff like that, because a job or anything like that, it just leaves us like that, basically. So at the end of the day, it's their fault that they put all these homeless people and people that beg and all that, is because if they were doing something for them, they might get more in their lives, you know what I mean? They would maybe get more in their lives, but they didn't do nothing for us, so I didn't see us going anywhere in their life, you know what I mean?
Honey, honey, good hair when you down at night.
Fucking bastard.
Look, I do like you, you know, but that doesn't mean you can take liberties with me. I mean, I've told you, I'm with someone. I have a boyfriend. You and me, we were getting on so well, and then you had to go and ruin it all. Why can't we be just good friends? I have so few real good friends in this world.
Sorry. I can't help it. I'm crazy about you.
Don't be silly. You're just crazy about my cleavage.
No, really, I'm mad about you. You're so irresistible. You blow me out of my mind. I can't help it when I'm with you. I'm leaning over you.
Leering over me.
I'm like a wee boy in a sweet shop.
Yes. And we all know how little boys get sticky fingers, don't we? Look, if you promise to behave yourself.
You don't blame me for being a mad, impetuous fool. You let us go on a Crip trip.
Yeah.
Me, riding from behind.
Hey, don't push your luck, bastard.
No, I didn't mean that. I meant me on your behind. No, I don't even mean that. What do you mean? I don't... Me...
She'd love it. She's a real rock music junkie.
Who?
Tina. She's the craziest woman I know.
Why didn't she come?
Can't. Too ill. Has been ill for 10 years now. Silicone disease. Progressive. Getting worse and worse. Everything failing. Like a mess. She's dying. But it's a slow, painful death. The silicone implants are leaking poisonous substances that are killing her.
Is there nothing they can do for her?
Well, I'm sure there are things. But she's dying because the government and the medical establishment refuse to accept that silicone causes fatal illnesses. She's without a doctor. The bastards keep throwing her off their list.
It's criminal, isn't it? Shouldn't be allowed. How dare doctors refuse to treat patients?
The NHS have a secret euthanasia policy. They regard us Crips as useless eaters.
Yeah, Hitler is not dead, eh? It's not just us. It's getting to be anyone who's over 65. I mean, don't put your granny in an old folks home. She'll be dead within 6 months. First they'll underfeed her, malnourished or maltreat her. They'll demoralise her, let her get ill. So she ends up in hospital. Then if that happens, bang, you can guarantee she's dead within a fortnight. Yeah, that's how the system operates. Deliberate murder. A state policy. You'd have even got this thing called DNR, do not resuscitate. Do you know what that means? Do not resuscitate. That means kill your fucking granny, that's what that means, man. If you're out of order, she can make you sick. When are people going to wake up, the state can go, I'm going to kill your granny. If your granny takes a heart attack, she's dead. Has your granny got to get help? No, your granny's not going to get help. She's dead. Who decides who's useless and who isn't? He? I'd love to put some of those bastards on trial. Fuckers.
Makes me sick. Blair's regime prefers to squander billions of taxpayers' money, killing thousands of men, women and children in Iraq, protecting oil supplies to America, rather than maintain British people with a proper healthcare, welfare, security and education system.
Jenkins is my name.
Jack Jenkins.
And I'm the vocalist.
And you're the vocalist?
Yes.
Yeah.
Can you tell me the influences that have shaped your music over the years?
For one thing, Sun Ra was not satisfied with the music that was being played. He wasn't satisfied with the musicians who were being left out of the mix as far as musicians being paid for what they were really worth. Mm-hmm. And so he decided to create his own music with his own philosophy, because his philosophy was more than the music. It was about the attitude. It was about the discipline. That you have to create. You have to, it's more than just the music, it's the philosophy. For instance, the music comes out of your whole being, out of your whole body, from your head to your toe. It's all music. Every bone in your body can vibrate. Because they're not interested in what you're doing. They are interested in making money.
Yeah.
Sun Ra was not interested in making money.
Right.
Because number one, you could have all the money on, you can make all the money on the planet, but when you leave, you can't take it with you. So what good is it?
Yeah.
And then not only that, the money is made of paper. Okay, so now what man has did to so-called control the money, now you gotta have plastic.
Yeah.
If you go to rent a car, you gotta have plastic. They don't want money, they want the plastic. Plastic comes from plastic mines. You see, the plastic, you throw it in the fire, it'll burn up. So what good is it? And then not only that, plastic, somebody will steal your plastic. So what good is that? But what you have when you create, you have something that they cannot steal what you create, you see. And not only that, when you create within yourself with your discipline and with your true spirit, they cannot destroy that.
What's your attitude about the Bush and Blair and things like that?
All these wars, they tried to kill the spirit of the people. And if your spirit is strong enough to create something that they can't kill, within your spirit, they cannot kill you.
Poets read political poems. People shout from the audience, give us poetry, not politics.
Well, as far as poetry goes, I'm a poet myself. And I created this poem that I call Mr. Mystery, which came from Sun Ra, but as far as what I felt should be said about Mr. Mystery, I said, Mr. Mystery. Deep purple and soft blue clouds in a rainbow-colored sky. Sun Ra went there when he left this place in a flying saucer that came from outer space. That's what Sun Ra taught. He taught about things from other places, from other planets. He taught that man on this planet is out of touch with the forces of the other worlds, of the other beings, of the other spirits. So I say, Mr. Mystery. Sun Ra left them with his orchestra and some secret sources that are on the planet still. That's why Sun Ra was sent here, to let people know that the world is not made of material things, it's made of spiritual things. And this is what he was demonstrating, and this is what he was trying to say to the people of the world, to the leaders of the world. It's about the spirit.
Two four leaves lead you home. You precious little thing, and I wonder how you know. Home. So listen to yourself, go on and on. I don't like the way that you don't
like me. Now you don't make a sound, you shut them all down. You put them all to rest with you, you did not be here. Pretty as you are, you've got that ugly side. Now I never know, I just feel it inside. But I like the way you talk. I like the way you'd walk with me. You walk with me. Try a little here, make it all on your own. That hopeless little thought got lost inside your head. Well, you know I'd be your friend no matter all the cost. Just don't know if I can face to see this all go wrong. Can explain the void in my soul. You look like you don't care, like those words mean nothing at all. So make your little wish and you keep this to yourself. Hide it all away, you know better now how to tell. But I like the way you talk, and I like the way you walk with me. Will you walk?
You take me for something that I'm not, and don't you take from me what little faith I've got, and don't you break me into a million drowning dots, because my heart is not a Ferris wheel of love. Love.